I think it's hard for a lot of people to have hope about the future of coral reefs. And I know the data, I know the science, and I still have hope. Coral reefs are actually phenomenally important to our planet. They only cover less than 1% of the ocean floor, but they support 25% of all marine life.
Coral reefs offer coastal protection, they offer subsistence, they offer jobs and livelihoods.
Without corals, no fish, no food, nothing. Community eat, live, depend on how the healthy coral it is.
Reefs are dying globally, and this is due to natural reasons and human-induced reasons. Pollution, invasive species, coral disease, as well as unsustainable coastal development. All of these pressures are working together. However, there's without a doubt that climate change is killing reefs way faster than they can rejuvenate and making those stressors a whole lot worse.
We have a window of opportunity, about 10 more years, to save the world's coral reefs. If we don't act, up to 90% of these critical ecosystems will be gone by 2050. The North Star for the Nature Conservancy is aligned with this global effort to protect 30% of our oceans, freshwaters, and lands. And in the coral reef space, we also aim to protect and restore 30% of coral and shellfish reefs over the next decade.
So we're trying to really build up capacity and leverage those partnerships to really scale up our impact, whether it's through innovative science, or it's through community engagements, or even if it's outreach and education, trying to build the next generation of coral reef stewards.
We are trying to test different techniques, to apply different techniques, just see how you can improve that and just apply them in different places.
So sometimes corals aren't actually able to recover on their own. We actually have to come in and do some interventions, and that means things like replacing the structure, putting substrate underwater that corals can grow and settle on. In some other cases, that means actually putting more coral in the water. So we would collect fragments from other spaces or other places, or we would grow them in the lab and then outplant them onto the reef.
It involves, you know, looking at how natural resources are being harvested on the coral reefs and other areas within the ecosystem and manage them in a sustainable way so the people can continue to utilize them and also to protect them for generations in the future.
Right now, they're working with us in terms of assisting us with zoning plans for a number of parks throughout the Bahamas. What we do hand in hand with the Nature Conservancy.
The Nature Conservancy works globally and has access to knowledge and partners across the world that really can drive innovation and get us to where we want to be.
So I've been in the field a long time. I've been doing marine conservation for 20 years. And I've seen big changes over time. And one of the things that gives me so much hope is how much leadership I'm now seeing at the local level to save their own reefs.
Mama rasa bangga karena karang yang sudah mati, yang sekarang kita jaga ini sudah bertumbuh dan masih sudah berkembang.
Our fundings at the state level are very limited. So through our friends and our partnership, through the NGOs, like PNG, we can sustain the healthy reefs for our people.
Losing reefs isn't just about losing something beautiful underwater. It's about losing all of those incredible services that these systems provide to communities around the world.
My father was a full-time fisherman, so I've seen a lot of fish. I've seen a lot of corals growing up. The baseline today has changed, and I would like my children to continue to see what I've seen.
Community, nature is not only belonging to one person, it's belonging to everybody, everyone. We have to protect it all together.